Hello, welcome to part 2 of creating Portal 2 maps within the Hammer Editor. In this video, we will learn how to create test chambers and other doors, buttons of all sorts, and how to create portable surfaces on walls. We will begin with doors. Open up the Hammer Editor and create a new map. Then, create 4 walls, a floor, and a roof. Now, select the Face Edit tool and change each of the outside wall textures to No Draw. You can hold the Control key and select the textures to change multiple at a time. Finally, select the Point Entity tool and place a player start inside of the room. Now, this is where the player will spawn. Duplicate the room by control selecting each of the blocks, holding Shift, and drag the room out to the other one. Also remember to delete one of the walls where the rooms join together. What we need to do now is create a hole for our door to exist within. That is 128 by 128. The best way to do this is to change our currently existing wall into 4 walls to create our hole. Select the wall and hold Shift, then drag it out of the other wall, but then back to the same position to create a clone in the same location. Continue using duplication like this to create 4 walls that are each 192 by 512. You should get a 128 by 128 hole in the middle where we can place our door. To get the door, simply place a point entity prop underscore test chamber underscore door. However, this does not come with a frame. Also, our wall is covered in no draw, which we don't want. Change these back to any texture. Place another point entity, this time being a funk instance. Set the VMF file name to instances/p2editor/door_frame_black.vmf. Nothing will happen, as we need to save our map to the correct location. Save it to the default Portal 2 maps file. Then, move the funk instance and rotate it. Fit it in the slot and adjust it. This part is actually really hard, as you need to set the grid to a very low setting. Then, we need to make our wall thinner to 32, as this is the door size. Now, we need to move our second room closer so there's no gap. Click F9 or go File, Run Map. Click OK. Now, let's create a button to open our door. Place a point entity and make it prop underscore button. This is a button, however it controls nothing. We need to link I/O to it, or basically just link it to the door. Select the button, click on the Outputs tab, and add an output. Here, we can set it to do something on pressed. We can't actually access the door unless we give it a name, so select the door to do that. Head back to the button to link it to the door, and make it open. Running this, we can see that the button will now successfully open the door. The next thing to do is create another door. Let's make a bar door. Place a point entity, make it a prop underscore dynamic, and set the world model to be models/props_underground/underground_door_dynamic.mdl and give it a name of door02, so we can link something to this. Draw a brush in front of it, about 32 pixels, and line it up with the door. Then, select it and click Ctrl T and set it to be a trigger once. Also, give it a texture of invisible. Give it a name of button02 so we can link it to the door. Add an output of onTriggerToTargetDoor02, set animation, and make the parameter be open. Add another output which will kill the button, so it can be clicked multiple times to reopen the door, which would look quite glitchy. Run the map again. Click E on the door, and nothing happens. Debug it. Set the button to be a funk button. Then head back to outputs, and change onTrigger to be onPressed. And also change the animation to have a lowercase o. And now, run again. Head up to the door and click E. The door should now open, and you can walk through it. Now, time for a floor button. A new point entity. A prop underscore floor underscore button. Then, try to position it on the surface. Something important we need is a button frame, so that it looks better. place a point entity, make it a func underscore instance, and set the VMF file name to be instances slash buttons slash button underscore pieces slash for underscore button underscore base underscore intact underscore black dot VMF. If you click browse, you should be able to see four different options for other button frames. Position the frame perfectly in the ground under the floor button. Now, duplicate the floor into four pieces, so that you can resize them and create a hole for the button frame. Ensure there are no leaks, which is when there's a connection from the inside to the outside world. I typically use to map load point file to see where leaks are. Now, run the map. The button looks alright, maybe we could place it better, but it looks fine for now. The last part of this video will be creating portable surfaces. This is really simple. We can use the same dividing method that we use with the floor to separate a wall. The hole to place a wall can be any size. Use the face edit tool to edit the texture to either a plaster texture or a tile texture. For this wall, I'm going to use tile slash white underscore wall underscore tile 003B. And that is it. To give our player a portal gun, place a portal entity, weapon underscore portal gun, and make sure it is next to or overlapping the player. Now, we can run a map. As it turns out, the text used for the rest of the walls is actually also a portable surface, but this wouldn't be the case if you had a black tile surface or similar. And that is it for today. Next video, we will focus on elevators and linking maps together. And please subscribe, as only 9% of people that watch these videos actually subscribe, so please consider subscribing. The video after that may begin to focus on creating our own Portal 2 mods, so watch out for that. Bye!